Lisanne Gaudreau in an athlete profile, and we're back to live action here at the University of Winnipeg's Duckworth Center and getting set for this provincial 4A boys championship final game. But before we do that, let's go to another athlete profile. We have Peter Young of the Vincent Massey Trojans. 54-54, Mike Haugh open, he's going to take that shot, and he hits it at the buzzer! The Vincent Massey Trojans will go on to the provincial AAA high school final!
Well, here we have...
The thrill of playing high school basketball is something most players will never forget.
Mike Haugh all alone.
For Vincent Massey's Peter Young, it has had many benefits.
You don't switch to follow, and they were following Mike Haugh.
Well, for me, just a friendship camaraderie I have with all my friends off in the summer I played basketball. And from then on, I've just been making great friends, and it's been great that way.
Inside, they've got Young, 45, but Robinson drives inside. Young picks up the offensive board, and he goes up strong, and we're tied at 31. Peter Young's doing an excellent job at the offensive glass. That's his second real big offensive rebound of this quarter. They're going to have to do some blockout against Peter Young. Tried to Penner. Penner from three-point range. Doesn't get it to go, and Peter Young now on the defensive end picks up
the
board.
In addition to being a strong rebounder, Young's role has many other facets.
Basically, I'm the floor leader, and I try to keep the guys intact during the game and pass the ball around, give the ball to the hot shooter. I have to score, rebound, pass. I have to use my whole game usually when I play for Massey.
According to Peter, Vincent Massey head coach Jerry Hildebrand has helped Young develop as a player in many ways.
Well, probably the most important part for me was how to become a leader on the floor and how to control a game. For me, that was Mr. Hildebrand did the most. He let me into, take the last shot, become a leader in that way.
I find him one of the most tenacious players that we have in the province. He's our quarterback on the floor. He handles the ball. Set a record the other night against Dakota with 26 assists in one game. He reads the floor extremely well. He contributes by scoring an average of 13.5 points a game and 8.5 rebounds per game. So Peter is our dynamic force that we look to. He's our general that directs the flow of what we call the four of the big people on the floor. And he's the person that we look to very strongly.
Provincial finalists last year, Vincent Massey was upset in the regional playdowns by arch rivals Dakota. Despite not being in the finals, Young described what it takes for a team to get to the championships.
Well, our defense has been lacking the last few games, and that's what we have to do. We have to concentrate on our defense, shut the hot shooter down, rebound really well, and obviously score more points than the other team.
In addition to being a fine student athlete, team leader, and class individual, Peter has had to live with another type of glory.
Do you find having a great name such as Peter Young, you get comparisons to the other Peter Young at CKY?
Well, I've met him a few times. I don't get much comparison to him. He's a little shorter than me, but I've always had jokes since I was a little kid.
Is it because you're a better human being than him that you don't often get comparisons to?
I don't know him personally, so I can't comment on that.
Thanks. Don't get me in trouble. Thanks.
Welcome back to the University of Winnipeg Duckworth Center as we are just a few moments away from the provincial Final Four Boys Championship Final. Dakota was knocked out by the Daniel Mac Maroons. Laurie, you know a lot about Daniel Mac. What are we going to see from them tonight?
Well, from Daniel Mac, you're going to see a high-paced, go at him, 94-feet basketball. What doesn't matter who Daniel plays, you're going to see an awful lot of ball movement, some very quick scoring, and you're going to see a lot of pressure. Daniel Mack goes after the ball big time. Their reflection of their head coach, Tony Scott. Tony played here at the U of W 1 year, then he played for Rick Suffield out at Lakehead, and that was the type of team that Tony is used to playing on, and that's what he's generated over to his players. So for those of you that want to see a very fast-paced game and a lot of action, that's what you're going to see from the Daniel McIntyre Maroons.
I think a lot of emotion is going to come from Transcona, but I understand Sean's got someone down at courtside, so we'll go down to Sean Coates.
Thanks. Joining me now at courtside is the assistant coach of the Winnipeg Thunder, the new professional basketball team in town, Vic Prude. Vic, could you tell us what some of the implications are of having a professional basketball team here in the city of Winnipeg?
Well, I think in terms of the context of the provincials, it's a tremendous opportunity for young people to watch world-class basketball. Only 234 players can play in the NBA, so the people are going to have a chance to watch and see some very, very good players, and hopefully we'll have some of these guys in a couple of years playing for the Winnipeg Thunder.
Okay, now I understand that you're going to have a walk-on tryout. When is that, and what does that involve?
On April the 17th, 1 to 4 p.m. at the University of Winnipeg, we have a walk-on camp, and that means that anybody who would like to try out for the Thunder is welcome to come to bring their running shoes, their shorts, and they'll get a crack at it.
Okay, great. Thank you. That's Vic Pruden, the assistant coach of the new basketball team here, new professional basketball team, the Winnipeg Thunder. And before we go back up, we've got Kevin Chief, last year's MVP from the provincial finals. Kevin, if you can join us right at the moment. Hi, Kevin. Youngest player ever to be MVP at this provincial championships. You won it last year. Tell me what these guys are going through right now. The crowd's building. What are they thinking?
I'm sure they're a little bit nervous. With so many people here, we are nervous, but we are very excited too. They'll be fine as soon as the game starts. Once they start playing, they'll be all right.
Okay. Now, I understand this is a big moment for these guys. Do you think nerves are going to be too much of a problem? I know you said once we get going, they'll be fine. Do you think some guys might carry it through with them throughout the game?
I'm sure there'll be a couple grade 11s that will be really scared coming off from a freshman team and stuff. But players like Kevin Brown and Daryl Baptiste and like the veterans will handle the pressure just like nicely.
Okay, thank you. That's Kevin Chief, TechVoc player and last year's MVP. Back up to you, Blair.
Well, Sean, Transcona beat Sisler in the first round, St. John's in round number two, and they upset the number one ranked Oak Park Raiders, pardon me, in semifinal action last night. And let's see highlights from those games.
In the first boys semifinal, it was number one ranked Oak Park versus Transcona. It was tight in the first quarter. And throughout the first half, here we see Oak Park's Jason Harrison with a steal and then a basket. He made the free throw to complete the three-point play. At the first half, Oak Park coach Darren Klapik was trying to shout some encouragement to his players. And there was much shouting going on as the Transcona fans came down trying to disrupt the Oak Park cheerleaders' routine. Oak Park's guys responded by running around the track, showing that team spirit certainly is in effect here at the provincial championships. In the second half, it was all Transcona. Titans number four, Vince Bueno, hit the first of two consecutive three-pointers to put his team up by seven, 43-36. Bueno was a long-range threat all evening for Transcona. Oak Park didn't give up, and they showed why they're ranked number one. They came back as strong as they could. Jason Harrison, the star player for Oak Park, gave a valiant effort hitting a jumper there. And he had some support from his teammates as well. Oak Park coaches Darren Klapik and Randy Cassano were very concerned about their team's effort and tried to do what they could to bring them back on. Jason Harrison got a little frustrated as the game went on, but he didn't give up, however, as he came back with a nice drive right here, splitting the defense and going up with a finger roll for the basket to make it close for Oak Park. Finally, though, for Transcona, it was their passing and quick offense that won it for them. In the end, the final score read Transcona 72, Oak Park 59. Player of the game for Oak Park was Jason Harrison. And somewhere down on the ground there, number four, Vince Bueno.
Well, Daniel Mack came into this tournament ranked number 2. They beat Crocus Plains of Brandon and then Dakota last night. We'll see those highlights a little later on because we're going to get set with action here. The number 2 ranked Daniel Mack Maroons take on the number 5 Transcona Titans. And we'll go down to our announcer, Bill Anthony, for the introductions of the starting lineups.
The Manitoba High Schools Athletic Association and the Manitoba Milk Producers Marketing Board welcomes you to the 1992 Varsity Boys Provincial 4A Basketball Championship Final. This evening's competition features the number 2 ranked Daniel McIntyre Maroons and the Cinderella team of this year, the Transcona Titans. Transcona Titans will be visitors on the scoreboard. This is the first varsity boys basketball team from TCI ever to be involved in a provincial tournament. What even makes this more amazing is that they have never been ranked higher than 5th all season and have come on strong to upset number 4 seed St. John's Tigers and last night upset the number 1 ranked Oak Park Raiders. Their record now stands at 34-5. Now let's meet the Suburban Conference champions, the Transcona Titans. Number 5, Tim McDowell. Number 10, Dan Maniluk. Number 24, Ramil Suminod. Number 30, Dan Richard. And number 34, Brad Cowick. We'll introduce the starting 5 shortly. The home team on the scoreboard, the Daniel McIntyre Maroons. Daniel Mack has had a strong season, winning 11 out of 12 league games and 2 tournaments. They've been ranked in the top 3 most of the year, coming into this year's final ranked 2nd. To advance to this year's final, they got by Crocus Plains 70-61, and last night had a marathon battle with Dakota, in which we saw the game tied 5 times and 6 lead changes. Daniel pulled it out in the 4th quarter, winning 57-50. Let's meet the city conference champions, the Daniel McIntyre Maroons. Number 5, Peter Cattigay. Number 11, Wendell Park. Number 15, Jason Santos. Number 20, Mark Howell. Number 32, George Valentim. And number 34, Charles Carlos. Now for the starting matchups. From Transcona, five-foot-10 guard number 4, Vince Bueno. 5'11" guard number 4, Daryl Baptiste. Transcona, 6'5" forward number 11, Kevin Brown. From Daniel McIntyre, 5'10" guard number 10, Ryan Oregas. From Transcona, Dakota, 6 foot tall forward, number 13, Ray Rahman. From Daniel McIntyre, 5 foot 11, number 12, Paulo Coelho. From Transcona, 6 foot six, post number 20, Peter Wicha. From Daniel Mack, 6 foot three, post number 21, Jeff Proskin. From Transcona, 6 foot four, post number 33, Jeff Jazer. From Daniel McIntyre, 5 foot 11, wing and number 23, Patrick Quigley. The coaches of the Transcona Titans, Jerry Bedu and Ted Bisson. For Daniel McIntyre, assistant coach Brian Ottenbride and head coach Tony Scott. The officials this evening, Mr. Charlie Kurtz and Mr. Jan Kreitzer.
Stay on your feet, box out, get boards, and then push the ball up every time. All right? Good job out there. Okay, let's go.
3, 2, 1, 3.
Well, Laurie, we are going to see some fast-paced action tonight.
Well, there's no doubt about it, Blair. Fast is going to be the name of this game. For the Transcona Titans, you just heard from Coach Bedu. He wants Transcona to push the ball up every time they can. And with Vince Bueno in the backcourt, that's going to happen. Daniel McIntyre Maroons, that's the way they've played all year long, and that's the way they're going to continue to play. Should be some very fast-paced, exciting action here, Blair.
Well, Lord, Daniel Mack will get the opening tip-off. They're in the white uniforms. They will move from right to left on your screen. The Transcona Titans in the green. They're going in the opposite direction. Number 10, Ryan O'Regas. They get the ball inside. The first shot, ball rolls away, and number 23, Patrick Quigley. And coming down with that one is Vince Bueno. He can hit those three-pointers, and he proved that last night.
Well, there's no doubt about that. There's good steal in there by number 12, Paulo Coelho. Here comes the Maroons running.
Coelho puts on the brakes and fires it off the glass. It doesn't fall. Very quickly, they come the other way. Hey, Hammond pulls that one up for the short jumper, and Transcona hits first.
Transcona's not going to put that much pressure on. They're going to play straight man-to-man. We'll see here when Daniel Mack scores, though, you're going to see an awful lot of pressure.
O'Regas from three-point range does not fall. They battle for the board. Great job there by number 23. Quigley to try to save that one. Just deflects it out of bounds.
That's a good job by Patrick Quigley. He works hard. You got to work hard against guys like Dusard and Brown.
2-0 lead for Transcona, and they have possession. What a matchup we'll see with those two-point guards. Shot from the outside. Bueno misses that first three-point opportunity. Daniel Mack comes away with it.
Good job by number 23, Jeff Proskin. Jeff's going to have to do real yeoman's work here. He's going to have to keep three-point call against Quigley when he put the ball back outside. Jeff Proskin's going to have to do a real big job on the boards.
Setting up now, the Daniel Mack Maroons on defense as they're playing man-on-man. A lot of pressure. Bueno, number four. He's going to be challenged by O'Regas all night long.
Well, some good matchups here. You've got Ryan O'Regas and Vince Bueno going head-to-head. Then on the wing, you've got Mike Brown and Gerald Baptiste. Good job by Brown. Right inside.
Nice pass inside. Number 11, Kevin Brown.
Good job by Transcona. When we see them come down the next time against Daniels man-to-man, they're setting up in a 1-4 offensive set. They go to either wing, and then they try and slide that post down.
Baptiste looking inside. They dish it back out. That shot from the outside. Good ball to Coelho, and then they get a rebound. ball. What a great job there for number 13, Ray Hammond, to save that ball. He was down on the ground.
It's a good job by Ray. We've had myself and a couple other coaches conversations. The way it looks is Ray Mahanan from Transcona is one of the best role players in the province.
Hammond tries again, but the rebound comes to number 20, and that's Peter Richard, and they dish it back out.
An excellent job by both teams right here. Transcona keeping the ball alive.
And they go back door, and they'll short cut number 33, Jeff Bizarre. Shot coming off the glass, and it won't fall from Baptiste. 6-0 lead for the Titans, and they go up court quickly. They're trying to dish that ball, and once again, it comes low. Rahaman pulls the ball back out for the Titans. Shot from the outside, Gisard for three.
Here's Transcona is off to their usual quick start. They're up 9-0. Daniel Mack's going to have to get a score here.
Daniel Mack's going to slow things down right now as they trail 9-0. They have yet to score in the first four, 3.5 minutes. Baptiste on a great move. Darryl Baptiste for two.
It's a good job by Darryl. They're going to have to go to Baptiste. Ray Mahammond, as we were saying, Ray's done an excellent job this year. He's one of the better role players in the province, but he's got his hands full and thinks he can play Darryl Baptiste.
Bizarre goes up and we got our first foul. That'll be a blocking foul, but picks that one up. The foul is going to go on number 23, I believe, for the Daniel Mack Maroons.
So what's going to happen there is number 23 for Daniel, Patrick Quigley. We would have got the charge, but I think Jeff Froskin reached in before that. I think the foul is going to go on Froskin, and that's going to put Jeff Gisard at the line.
Jeff Froskin picking up his first personal foul, the team's first. Jeff Gisard.
Going to have a big block out here by Quigley and Froskin.
Gisard successful on both free throws, and 11-2 Titan lead. The number 5-ranked Transcona Titans taking on the 2nd-ranked Daniel Mack Maroons. And a motion coming out front now for the Titans. And a great move inside there by number 12, Cuejo. And we got a basket and a chance for a 3-point play.
That's a good job by Paulo Cuejo. Once again, you can see the quickness of Daniel Mack. On the one wing, you've got Paulo Cuejo. On the other wing, you've got Darryl Baptiste. If Transcona is going to stay man-to-man, they're going to have to stop that penetration.
Cuejo moved inside. The rebound coming number 21, Jeff Proskin. He puts it in, and he'll go the line. Transcona foul on number 20, Peter Wicha. His first personal defeat first. Battle for the boards, and coming down with it is Gisard for the Titans. Bueno now just gets it across for Hammond, 13.
Daniel Mack once again, straight man-to-man.
A lot of pressure will be put on by both teams. Outside, 2-point opportunity from Gisard, goes to three.
That's Gisard who happens to be on fire once again. Excellent defense by Daniel Mack at pushing Transcona out beyond the 3-point line, but Transcona seems to score every time they come down.
Cuejo for two. 14-6, an 8-point Titan lead. 5 minutes, 20 seconds to go in this first quarter. 10 points right now for Gisard. Brown from the outside. Battles for his own rebound. He'll pick up the foul. A foul on number 11, Kevin Brown. His first personal, the team's second of the quarter.
Well, Kevin, a little bit out of sync there. We had Daniel Mack with Baptiste and Arregas tried to double on Bueno, leaving Mike Brown open. Mike took the shot, but that is not going to go on Mike Brown. They're going to give Ray Rahaman that foul.
Ramil Sumanod comes into the game for the Transcona Titans. We move down to 5 minutes. Cuejo from the outside for two.
A good job by Paulo Cuejo. Here's another one. It's a great 10 student here. If he gets on the run, it's going to be something else. I think we got it rolling. The travel ball by Jeff, but he gets away with it, concentrates on the hoop, and does an excellent job.
Gisard with 12 points is a 16-8 Titan lead. Orega steps outside. The ball inside now to number 23, Quigley. They dish it back out once again. 8-point lead for the Titans. 4.5 minutes remaining here in this first quarter. Orega's great ball handling skills, but he loses the ball. And the ball's knocked out of bounds again. This time, Transcona will maintain possession, and quickly they inbound.
Well, that time at the offensive end, Orega's called for the clear out. You saw Darryl Baptiste clear out, let Ryan Orega's go one-on-one. This time we've got Bueno going one-on-one against Oregas, and Ryan picks up the foul.
Ryan Oregas picking up his first personal foul, the team's second of this half. 4 minutes, 23 seconds remaining. If you can see number four there, Vince Bueno, he is trying to work out a cramp. Last night at the end of the semifinal action, he had a major cramp in his left calf and was down for quite a long time. And I think it's starting to bother him again as this game starts, Lloyd.
Well, Vince was down, as you said. It was quite a cramp. Hopefully, there was a lot of fluid that was taken in during the day today. And he's got to make sure that he's stretched out properly.
Great pass inside to Sumanod, and then he dives on the floor. A jump ball with the arrow in possession of the Titans.
That's going to go transcone away. Unfortunately for Daniel Mack, a little bit of confusion. They can't afford these silly little turnovers.
Number 24, Ramal Sumanod comes into the game as a substitute and played very well here. He opened this first quarter. A great steal by Ryan Oregas.
What we've got to do if we're Ray, we've got to understand we're inbound the ball against a lot quicker people. Baptiste takes the hole. Great job by Wendell Park at the offensive end.
Wendell Park again. And he doesn't get it to fall a third time, but the ball comes right back to the Maroons. Wendell Park is a great vertical, Lori. Shot from the outside from number 23, Quigley, and Titans pull it down.
Unfortunate for Daniel Mack at that end of the floor that time.
16-8, 3 minutes, 40 seconds. Ball inside to Brown, it's off of his hands. Maroon ball.
Good job by Transcona as they try the back door to Vince. Transcona stays man-to-man.
Both teams in that man-to-man defense. A lot of pressure being put on. Oregas from the inside of the key. Off the front iron, a good job there. Guajo back, dishes it back out to Baptiste. Baptiste from three-point range. Off the front iron. And very quickly, Transcona turns the tables. Bueno uses the glass and doesn't get it to fall.
Once again, as we mentioned at the beginning of the show here, we're going to get some fast-paced action.
Inside 3 minutes, sorry, Lloyd.
Baptiste's got to get in the flow of things here.
Baptiste driving to the hoop.
He's doing a great job in terms of his penetration, but the shot's there. He just doesn't feel comfortable with it. He had a little bit of a problem last night in terms of getting off right at the beginning, and he's a little bit hesitant.
Well, on number 13, Ray Rahamon, and he picks up his first personal foul. Pardon me, that's his second personal foul. The team's third.
As we mentioned, Ray's a very integral part of this Transcona team, and Coach Padu cannot afford to lose him.
Oregas from the outside, and number 33, Jazard, is there on the defensive end for the Titans.
Daniel Mack getting some very easy opportunities here. Wide open shots, they just have to convert those.
Ball's deflected, great hands on number 10, Ryan Oregas, but not able to maintain control. Daniel continually comes up with these very quick point guards, Laurie, every year. Not very big, but quick.
Excellent job by Oregas. There's Quigley stepping into the lane. Here comes Transcona, 3-on-1. Quigley going to go to the hole.
Quigley loses possession. Is Jazard going in there to intimidate him?
That bothers Coach Scott, but from this angle, that's a ball check by Jeff Jazard. Unfortunately, Coach Scott's going to have to live with that one.
You can hear that slap from here on the ball. Transcona trying to break very quickly. They throw the ball out of bounds. So a turnover, and we remain at 16-8. Baptiste now, number 4, pulls up the jumper. Strong on that one, and number 30 pulls down the board. Dan Richard for the Titans.
Once again, at that offensive end, Darryl's got to get into some sync. He's been fighting it all week so far, and it just hasn't been able to click. But there's lots of time left.
Inside, 2 minutes remaining in this first quarter. Sorry, looks inside to Brown. Brown with a turnaround jumper. A battle for the board. Daniel Mack will come away with it. That foul, number 11, Kevin Brown.
Well, Kevin, a little bit of a frustration foul there. We're kind of lucky if we're Transcona right now, because that's really Kevin's second. However, it's Ray Rahamon who's sitting on the bench with one of Kevin Brown's fouls.
First team foul on Kevin Brown. The team's fourth. Daniel Mack will inbound the ball as they trail by 8. In the last few minutes, we've had no scoring, Laurie, so the pace has settled down.
Well, as we said, it was going to be fast. We didn't lie, Blair. They came out guns firing, Transcona did, and they've done an excellent job. Right now, it seems that we're starting to get into a little bit of a sink. And there we go. Great offensive board by Jeff Blossom. And he's scores and did an excellent job.
Yep. Kroskin, once again, will go the line with a chance to complete a three-point play. He cut the Titan lead down to six with that bucket.
What's got to happen here, once again, I'm not trying not to get on Daryl's case, but he's just got to calm down and get into the flow of things. You also got to understand that for Coach Scott, Daryl Baptiste always takes the best offensive player from the other team. And so defensively, he has to work so hard, it only makes sense that every once in a while his offensive output might suffer.
Dan Richard picking up his first personal foul, the team's fifth. At the line, Jeff Kroskin completes a three-point play. That's 16-11, five-point Titan lead. About 4 minutes now since Transcona has scored. Shot from the outside, Bueno off the iron. They battle for the loose ball. Number 11, Wendell Park comes down with that ball for the Danny Mac Maroons.
Well, that's a very interesting no call by referee Kreitzer right there. I thought that we were going to have Brown pick up his second.
Baptiste from three-point range. A great move from number 23, Patrick Quigley.
Once again, Daryl Baptiste unable to convert, but a great putback by Quigley. Got to stay with the ball. Don't back off Vince.
Bueno for his first two.
The cardinal sin by Daniel Mack right there. We had teams that have done that have made that mistake just far too often. Oak Park did it before Oak Park and St. John's in the semifinals. You got to stay with the ball when it's in Vince Bueno's hand.
Baptiste with a great move inside. He hits the roll for two.
Daryl's doing a great job inside. The shooting is quite there from the outside, but he's making up for it by taking that ball inside, really making the Transcona defense work hard.
18-15 for the Titans, 20 seconds remaining. Brown from the outside, he hits for 3 points.
It's a good hit by Kevin Brown. Once again, Jeff Kroskin just laid off a little bit. We've got to understand if we're the Danny McIntyre Maroons. We've seen the Transcona offense. We can see how it could put out. You've got to stay with the man with the ball. You've got to stay on him tight.
Mark Howell off the back iron with just 1 second remaining. Shumanin throws it down and almost canned it. And we come to the end of the first quarter. The Transcona Titans, who jumped out to a 10-0 lead, lead by a score of 21-15.
An excellent job by both teams. You get a look there on your screen, 21-15 in favor of the Titans. We mentioned very early in the broadcast, Blair, that it was going to be a very up-tempo game, and that's exactly what we've seen thus far.
Transcona came out strong, the fifth-ranked Titans in their first provincial final. And let's go down to head coach Terry Bedu and see what he has to say.
I told you, they shoot out there. You gotta get a hand up.
We got something going, all right? Defensively, when Baptiste goes inside on you, you're jumping and he's going around you anyway. So don't jump. Get in front of him and make him shoot over something instead of jumping up in the air so he can go around you.
Okay?
Okay, let's go.
The other thing is we've got to come out and have pressure on the ball. Vince can't come down here to throw up and take jump shots on us. Popped out. From now on.
You all right, Vince? Vince. Go. Okay?
We heard from both coaches there, Laurie, and showing a little different set of instructions.
Well, in terms of Coach Bedu, he's very straightforward. Like what he wants his team to do, they got to make Daryl play. Don't let him get around you. Stay down on the floor. We know that Daryl's struggling a little bit with his outside shooting. When he takes the ball into him, don't go for the head fakes. Don't move. He wants him to stay down. On the other side there, Coach Scott, he's a little bit of a wake-up call for his guys here, a little bit of a head shake. You know that you got to stay with the ball. You can't leave people out there because they'll shoot from out there.
Second quarter just underway, 21-15 lead. Wendell Park, number 11, they dish the ball back outside. Cuejo for two.
That's a good job by Paulo Cuejo. Paulo can really fill it up once he gets going here.
Cuejo hits 2 points. He has six in the game. It's down to a four-point Titan lead.
Interesting defensive matchup here. Cuejo on Brown.
Semenod moves in, tries to get the roll, and Oregas comes away with it. Very quickly now, they come back down court. Cuejo again trying to get that one. A great job by Oregas.
Good job by Daniel Mack once again.
Chance now for the Maroons to cut this tight lead to two.
Good ball movement here by Daniel.
Howell from the outside. Once again, his shot hits a back iron, but comes back out.
Good job by Jeff Proskin on the offensive boards. In his timeout, Coach Badu said, stay down, make Daryl Baptiste shoot over you. The other thing he said is you need some offensive rebounds. I should say some defensive rebounds, cut down on Daniel's chances.
Jeff Jazard comes away with a rebound, and very quickly the Titans break up court. Nice pass inside. We got Jeff Jazard going to the line with a chance to complete a three-point play.
That's an excellent job by Transcona. You see, Daniel came down, had three shots at it, didn't come away with anything. They could have tied that game up, and now we come down, of course. Good ball movement, and Jazard is doing a great job here for Transcona.
Wendell Park picking up his first personal foul, the team's third of this half, at the line with a chance to complete that three-point play. Number 33, Jeff Jazard.
Jeff Jazard, 14 points.
Looks like we're going to have an officials timeout here from the top of the track here at the U of W. We got some popcorn down on the playing surface, so
we got the referee Kreitzer
takes it out.
Now the here we go, we're going to listen to Coach Scott here. That is a flash. You guys can get the ball, they don't play good defense. Look for these inside people.
Tony Scott, a head coach of the Daniel Mac Maroons. Daniel Mac has gone through a few head coaches in the last few years. I don't know whether it's just teachers coming or going or the depth of coaches they have in that school level.
Well, a lot of coaches at Daniel Mac, a lot of people have been through the ranks, a lot of very good coaches, and it's shown in terms of the success of the program. The last coach that we had at the varsity level, of course, was Mr. Dwayne Brothers, who's moved out to the West Coast, and is now as an assistant coach with the UBC Thunderbirds, who are involved in the national tournament right now.
Jeff Jazard hitting that free throw, and it's a 24-17 lead for the Titans. And a great steal there from number 13, Rahaman. And another great steal on the other end from O'Regas. 2-on-1 now. Park goes in off the glass.
Wendell Park takes it to the glass hard. Ryan makes up for a very poor pass there with the quick hands, as you mentioned, Blair. Once again, another point guard of Daniel. Very quick, very good hands.
Leno going up and firing that one. Goes long. Wajo pulls that one down, and very quickly the Maroons turn the tables. The ball's picked up now in a battle for it, and it will go over to the Titans. They look down court very quickly. Rahaman going up, trying to put it off on a great defensive move by Jeff Proskin.
Great job by Jeff Proskin there. Ryan O'Regas, what he's got to do is just settle down. Here's an open jumper here. Passes it up.
O'Regas brings the ball back out top. Look inside to Proskin. He loses possession.
That's a good look by Wendell Park. Jeff's got to make sure that he looks the ball right into his hands.
Hammond picking that one up, and he runs down to the low post. Bueno being challenged by O'Regas. They got to take the ball back out.
Good job by Ryan O'Regas at the defensive end. He's doing a great job.
Brown now trying to penetrate, and he's fouled on the play.
That foul again will go against Cuejo. What happened there? Paulo got a little bit out of sync, and Kevin got a step on him.
Paulo Cuejo picking up his first personal foul, the team's fourth. Transcona to inbound the ball from underneath the basket.
Good job here by Daniel Mack. They pick up the switch. Good cut by Ray.
Bueno moves that ball in to Rahaman, who cut down low for two.
Well, that's Patrick Quigley, lost his man there at the defensive end.
Rachel trying to get that one. That one. And number 23, Patrick Quigley, will pick up his first personal foul, the team's fifth of this half.
Patrick trying real hard there, compounds his first error with another one there. Reaches in. What we've got to do if we're Daniel Mack, we're going to play that real up-tempo, in-your-face, man-to-man defense. You've got to make sure you keep your check in view at all times.
Daniel Mack coach Tony Scott looks on with under 7 minutes to go. His team down by seven. Hit that nine. Number 24, Sumonad, picks up his first 2 points of the game.
Well, we've got somebody there completely missed the block out.
Ruskin now up high, looking to dish that ball off to someone. Wajo, it is partially deflected by Jarvis Proskin, gets it back and puts it in for two.
That's another great job by Jeff Proskin. Little two-man game there on the wing with Proskin and Wajo.
Brown, now number 11, throws it cross court. For Hamann, trying to look inside, just dishes it back to Brown. Nice feed in, but Proskin with a great job of cutting off that passing lane.
But once again, a great defensive read by Jeff Proskin there. Turns the ball over. Dan, you can follow within five here.
Baptiste trying to kiss one off the glass and unsuccessful. Daniel Mack, though, pulls the ball back. With 20, Mark Powell will set up the offense for the Daniel Mack Maroons. They trail by 7. 5 minutes, 45 seconds remain in this first half.
Ray Rahman's doing a great job on Daryl Baptiste.
Ruskin with a turnaround. Now we get the roll, and Bueno pulls it down.
It's a good job by Proskin. Once again, Daryl Baptiste going to have to work a little bit harder at the offensive end if he wants to get open.
Offense now from the Titans. So Hammond trying to look inside. This is off the Zard. Knocked it around. So the Titans go inbound. Subs coming into the game. Number 5, Peter Kattagay for the Daniel Mack Maroons. He'll replace Mark Howell.
Well, we get a look on our screen there. Transcona enjoying a 7-point lead, 28-21. That substitution by Coach Scott, number 5, Peter Kattagay, who you see on your screen now. You're going to see a bundle of energy right here, Blair.
A lot of very quick people on the Daniel Mack side. They bring in another one, number 5, Kattagay, and he's right on Bueno. Bueno trying to go up over top of him, and he comes up short. Good job of defense by Kattagay.
It's a good job by Peter. He's there just simply to molest, and he got away with that there.
Kattagay from the outside. Another great board by Proskin. And number 21, Jeff Proskin, almost had the opportunity for another three-point play.
Jeff Proskin's just doing a great job for Daniel Mack. He's really played well this last month of the season. Last night he was the player of the game, and he's just simply moved his game up a notch. And he's one of the unsung heroes there on that Daniel team with all the speed and the scoring ability that a lot of the other players possess. We saw Cheryl Little in the girls' final just before. We're going to keep looking at another player here who's coming to his own, number 21, Jeff Proskin for Daniel Mack.
Jeff Desjardins picking up his first personal foul of the team, 6. At the line, number 21, Jeff Proskin. He's successful on his first real. He goes 2 for 3 to the line for the first down. That's 3 for 4, down to a 5-point Titan lead, and they throw the ball away.
Daniel pressure right here once again.
5 minutes remaining in this second quarter, 28-23, the Titans lead. Baptiste now going for that three-pointer off the back iron. Good job by Rahana to pull it down.
Once again, Daryl not in any sync at all, and if you notice, he took that shot from the baseline and just stood there and watched it. He had enough time there. He could come in and get his own rebound. He's just got to get in a little more sync at the offensive end. That's all.
11 looking inside to Desjardins. Goes up over top, but Proskin's right there with great defensive position.
It's a good job by Proskin once again. So far, he's been the player for Daniel Mack here in the first half.
Kattagay trying to bounce that ball inside, and they get it. Number 23, Patrick Quigley for two.
That's a great job by Patrick as he takes it up. Kattagay's got a turn right here, got to turn some of them with the ball.
4 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in the first half. 28-25, back down to a 3-point lead. This is as close as Daniel's been since the opening tip-off when the Titans rolled out to a 10-0 lead.
Good job by Quigley.
Quigley will be called for the foul.
No. Once again, I guess referee Kreitzer has a better look at it than we do, but I think that's a pretty soft call right there when we look at the tempo at which this game's being played.
Patrick Quigley picking up his second personal foul, the team 6. So a foul on either team will put the other team at the bonus line with 3 minutes 56 seconds remaining in this second quarter. 28-25, the Titans lead, and you are watching the Provincial Boys Championship Final live here from the University of Winnipeg on BPW Channel 11. I'm Blair DeGray, along with Corey May. Bueno off the front iron. He had about 3 of those in the semifinal against Oak Park last night. They dish it back out, and Kattagay trying to make the steal. Travel ball!
That's Peter Kattagay was good lockout again. That's about the second or third time that's happened. And Coach Scott's going to make the substitution here. Good job by Ray Raman, though, with Quigley with a second, taking the ball at him right away. What Quigley's got to do again, he's got to make sure that he keeps sight of his man.
Number 11, Phil Park is subbed back into the game for the Maroons. 28-25, 3.5 minutes. Park now on the left-hand baseline. Back to Baptiste. Baptiste goes up high. Still cannot get it to fall.
Baptiste just cannot get that ball to fall. He's really starting to question himself there. That time he was thinking of taking the ball to the hole, and yet he tried to shoot it, and once again missed an easy opportunity.
Hammond finds the opening, dishes it across to Brown. Very quickly, Baptiste with a steal. 2-on-1 with Origas. Nice bounce pass to Origas. One-point ball game.
That's a great job by Darryl Baptiste, not being selfish, moves the ball up the floor.
Regis with his first 2 points, and it's answered by Bueno for two. Back to a three-point tight lead.
That's a good job by Vince, taking the ball right back. We have Danny Max going to have to get a little bit quicker in terms of coming back on defense. Putting a lot of pressure in the forecourt, but they've got to make sure that they get back.
Bueno now with 4 points. Cattigay trying to move in. Dumana takes that ball away, but it comes back to Park.
It's a good job there by Peter. I think what we've got to do if we're Daniel Mack, Ray's got two on him already. We got to go to Baptiste.
Baptiste again driving the paint and hits the Peter.
Bottom line is for Daniel Mack, Darryl Baptiste, one of their nickel players, you've got to go to him.
Brown from 3-point range. Back to a 4-point tight lead.
That's a good job by Daniel Mack, and then a great counter by Transcona. They just are on fire. They just keep hitting it. That's going to be Ray's third, and that's what you got to do if you're Daniel Mack. You got to keep going down inside to Darryl Baptiste.
Ray Hammond picking up his third personal foul, and that should send the Daniel Mack Maroons to the bonus line.
What Daniel Mack's got to understand, as soon as they score, they got to get their transition going. Once we get where we've got a movement there in terms of... this foul's going to go against Darryl Baptiste.
The foul has gone against Darryl Baptiste, and that's his first personal foul. And
referee Kreiser had a different view. It looked like it was way all over him, but I guess he called Darryl Baptiste for the offensive push.
There's Transcona, head coach Jerry Badu, and assistant Ted Besson. Jerry's been at Transcona for a number of years coaching basketball, and now he's got a team in the championship final. And Hammond not able to get it going. Park gets up high and pulls it down for the Maroons.
It's a good job by Wendell.
33-29, a minute 50 remains in this first half. The Titans out in front by four. Wajo just dishes the ball back out. Howell by himself, he's not going to shoot it. Pulls it around and looks once again for the Maroon offense to set up. Ruskin now inside, he puts it back out. Daniel Mack taking a lot of time to set up their offense. Shot from the outside, Howell. Right there, O'Regas tries to steal it, and Kevin Brown comes away with it for the Titans. Brown with a nice move for two, and he'll go to the line.
It's a good job by Mike Brown. Once again, you got Daniel Mack down the other end. It just doesn't click for them. And a great counter, as usual, by Transcona.
Number 20, Mark Howell will pick up his first personal foul at the line for the second time with a chance to complete a three-point play. Number 11, Kevin Brown.
Once again, Danny McIntyre Maroons. There's nothing wrong with controlling the ball. But what happens with Mark Howell on the floor, he's just a little bit too tentative. What he's got to do is he's got to put the ball up, or we got to look for people that are going to put the ball up. And in this case, on the floor at that time, he's got to look to Aragas or Quajo.
Kevin Brown unsuccessful. Brown with 10 points in the game looking for the steal. Quajo just able to hang on to that one past the midcourt line. We move inside. 1 minute remaining in this first half. Cattigay, number 5, this is Quajo. Daniel Mack once again will pull the ball out, trying to set up down low.
Daniel Mack's got to start looking at both ends of the floor here. Both sides of the floor as well.
Jeremy Lloyd Transcona still in that man-to-man defense. Cattigay pulls that ball around.
Well, what's going to happen here is Coach Scott's decided they're going to go for one shot.
inside, 30 seconds remaining. Number five, Peter Kattigay at the top. Move that ball about 10 seconds, Lloyd, before they start
to
open.
With about 10 or 12 seconds left, they're going to go. They're going to have to be a lot more protective with this ball than they are. Got to look for Ryan Arregas to take this now.
Inside 10, Arregas has possession. His first personal, and that'll set number 10, Ryan Arregas, to the line to shoot the bonus.
It's a good job by Daniel Mack in terms of moving the ball, but as we can see, they start to put themselves to sleep as well, and I don't think Daniel was aware, once again, of how much time there was on the clock. We're going to get Ryan Arregas to go to the line here to shoot the bonus.
Ueno picking up his first personal foul. Coach Scott from Daniel Mack shouting out instructions. 5 seconds to go on the clock. Clock by 35-29. 6-point lead in favor of the Transcona Titans.
Well, what we got to look at here, if Ryan's got to make sure that he makes his first one or get ready for Transcona to break.
Arregas has 3 points now in this first half.
Daniel's going to put a lot of pressure on here if Arregas makes this. We've got to watch the Transcona break, however.
A 4-point Transcona lead. Again, that pressure, and very quickly they try to go down court to Brown. A good steal there. Cuejo going to knock it away with just 2 seconds left. And Park at the buzzer. No, that shot will not count. As though it went in, it will not count as the buzzer had gone. So after one half of play, the Transcona Titans lead the Daniel Mack Maroons 35-31.
Good job by both squads. As we said, as we look at Coach Badu and his Titans leave the floor, Blair, we said there was going to be a fast tempo to this game, and there has been that. As far as Transcona is concerned, they've got to be very happy with what they've done, and they're leading with a 4-point lead. For Coach Scott and the Daniel McIntyre Maroons, they've got to be a little bit worried, however. They've given up some very easy baskets. They've given up a lot more offensive boards than they would like, and they've got to get Daryl Baptiste on a roll, and offensively they got to look to Ryan Arregas, and I think that Paulo Cuejo is going to have to step up a little bit more as well.
Well, Transcona really jumped out to an impressive 10-point lead, Laurie, and Daniel Mack, I think, was in shock.
Well, there's no doubt about it. We know that Transcona starts so quickly, and Daniel Mack, even though you know it's going to happen, you know that they're capable of it. Once again, you can't help but be shocked when you look at the offensive display that the Titans can put on.
Well, Daniel Mack won this provincial championship back in 1987-88. Again, they've had a number of good teams in the last few years. And back in the early 80s, Laurie, you led them to a provincial championship in 83-84. But also your teams were in the Final Four a couple of years and lost out in quarterfinals.
Yeah,
once.
We were lucky in the early 80s, Blair. We had some exceptional athletes that came to Daniel through the junior high feeder system, and a lot of those athletes did go on to play university ball. We were in the finals. We were fortunate enough to be in the finals the 4 years that I coached at Daniel. We got knocked out in a final a couple years in a row. We lost in the eights 1 year, and 82-83 were fortunate enough to win the big one.
Well, Daniel Mack has a tradition here in the championship final. Transcona looking for their first one, and we'll go down to Sean Coates at floor level.
Thank you, Blair. Joining me now at courtside is the assistant coach, or the head coach, I should say, for the provincial juvenile team and assistant coach for the University of Winnipeg Westman women's team, Mr. Craig Kendi. Craig, tell me about the tournament that you've seen here so far and some of the kids that could end up playing on your team this summer.
Well, Sean, it's been a great tournament. There were 7 girls from our juvenile program last year playing in the Final Four. And, you know, just a great game to watch. And Cheryl Little, who will hopefully play in the juvenile this year, had an outstanding game from the provincial program. Of course, Andrea Pales, who played last year. So the provincial program is doing a good job, I think, in getting kids to play at an elite level. You know.
Now, obviously, I guess part of the purpose of the juvenile program is to develop basketball talent, and as you mentioned, 7 kids were in the final today. What else does it do in terms of development?
Well, I think it prepares athletes for university competition, Sean. We have a very intense program, a lot of work on individual fundamentals, decision-making in basketball, so they're not running plays, but when they get the ball, what decisions do they have to make? Conditioning program is very important, as well as diet, things like that. So it prepares them to go on to an elite level of athletics.
Excellent. Okay, and just briefly, talk about the boys' team. Obviously, you're not coaching the boys' juvenile team, but maybe mention a couple of players here tonight that could end up playing on that team.
Yeah, we were fortunate to work with Coach Taylor last year, and of course, Daryl Baptiste, who played with the juvenile last year, will be back again. And he was very strong. I don't know whether he'll move up to junior or not. Kevin Chief, who has made the final, or well, not made the finals, but his team was involved in the final process, will probably be back. York Park's brother at Daniel Mack, an excellent athlete, and I would think he would have a good shot of making the juvenile program as well. As far as Transcona, I mean, they're a veteran team, all in grade 12, so I think they're all too old. But Daniel Mack looks like a young team, and as I say, Daryl Baptiste should be back, and he'll be a powerful force to reckon with.
Great. Well, thank you for those comments, Craig, and good luck this summer with your program.
Thanks very much, Sean.
Okay, back to you, Blair.
Thank you very much, Sean. The other day, Sean had a chance to meet up with Daniel Mack head coach Tony Scott, and Tony talked about at that time what it would take to win this provincial championship, and we'll hear those words from Tony Scott.
I think a couple of key things we have to look at. One is forcing some pressure on their perimeter game. Vince handles the ball for him a lot. Maybe forcing him to use some of the other skills besides penetrating and pitching to the three-point shooters. Another aspect I think we're going to have to control is probably their size difference. They're a lot bigger than we are, and their big guys are allowed to keep the ball alive for them and get second and third opportunities at those perimeter shots. Hopefully we'll be able to push the ball up on them and force them to maybe get a little bit tired and change their pace of game. That's some of the effective things we're looking at for tonight's game.
Well, as we mentioned in the beginning of this game, Daniel Mack won their semifinal game last night with a win over the Dakota Lancers, 57-50, and we have highlights from that action.
The boys' second semifinal featuring Daniel McIntyre and Dakota was anything but relaxing. It was a tight match all throughout. Dakota established an early lead, and it was the John Hannock Daryl Baptiste show for a while as the two star players exchanged baskets. Daryl Baptiste with a three-pointer kept Daniel Mack close. However, at the half, Martin Riley and his Dakota Lancers had a three-point lead, 26-23. It wasn't until the second half of play that Daniel Mack got their first lead. With that three-pointer, it made the score 47-44, Daniel Mack. Tony Scott was urging his team on, hoping they could play to their potential. Martin Riley, in return, tried to spur his boys on as the pressure became tight. Playing a strong game for Dakota was Clem Francis, hitting this short 6-foot baseline jumper. And with this breakaway layup, Francis tied the game at 49-all. The Daniel Mack free throw at the end made them extend their lead to 56-50. And with a final score of 57-50, Daniel McIntyre moves on to the finals. John Hannock was player of the game for Dakota. Well, for Daniel McIntyre, John Proskin was the player of the game.
And we're back now at the University of Winnipeg's Duckworth Center. A few months ago, this athletic center was named in honor of the former chancellor of the University of Winnipeg, Henry Duckworth, and we will take you through a brief profile of the University of Winnipeg's athletic center.
Located in the heart of the city, the University of Winnipeg proudly offers a combination of academic excellence, stimulating campus life, and a rich history of sporting and community achievement. located prominently on campus, is the Duckworth Center, named after Dr. Henry Duckworth, the second president of the university. Duckworth Center serves as home court for both men's and women's basketball and volleyball teams. Each varsity program competes successfully on a national level, and the Duckworth Center is the focal point of the action. However, the award-winning facility, completed in 1984, is synonymous with much more than intercollegiate court play. As part of the University of Winnipeg's long-standing commitment to serving the surrounding urban community, the Duckworth Center is open to over 150 inner-city and special needs groups per year. The list of facilities is impressive. Three regulation-sized gymnasiums that allow several programs to be conducted simultaneously without conflict. One auxiliary gym used extensively for aerobics and martial arts classes. A 167-meter banked running track complete with recessed railings for visually impaired joggers. Four racquetball and two squash courts, plus meeting and lecture rooms. There are also weight training facilities for a complete workout, plus an athletic and physiotherapy center. Other innovative and exciting features of the complex include complete handicap access to all areas and equipment, licensed lounge and banquet facilities, VIP seating for various sporting events, retractable seats for nearly 2,000 people, and the Westman Ware Sports Shop. The Duckworth Center is open to intramural volleyball and basketball, community events, summer sports camps, and skills development clinics, such as a volleyball clinic with TSN commentator and former national coach Vic Lindahl. Each is important in maintaining the vitality of the complex. For more information, contact the Duckworth Center, University of Winnipeg, 400 Spence Street, Winnipeg, Manitoba, R3B2E9. Committed to the community, in the heart of the city, the University of Winnipeg. Was underwritten in part by Air Canada.
That evening was one of the good times.
This program is presented in part by the milk producers of Manitoba.
Transcona Titans are on the run, both on the court and around the Duckworth Center, and they lead the Daniel Mac Maroons 35-31 as we get set for second half action here at the University of Winnipeg's Duckworth Center.
Well, in terms of second half action here, Blair, we're going to see exactly the same thing as we saw in the first half. It's going to be up-tempo, upbeat basketball, and Transcona is going to have the first shot at it here.
35-31, the Titans lead. He's blocked on the play by number 10, Ryan O'Regis, and O'Regis will pick up his second personal foul, the team's first of this second half.
It's a good job by O'Regis. He's on Vince, but he's just on him a little bit too tight. Good job by Vince Bueno, and Ryan picks up his first personal foul.
Bueno at the line, been successful in that first free throw opportunity.
Patrick Quigley and Jeff Proskin. You've got to have a big block out here against Brown and Jazard.
Number four, Vince Guerrero gets the roll, and it's now a 5-point Titan lead.
Grant Corner once again stays man-to-man.
Baptiste now on the left-hand side, comes back across the middle, dishes it out. Wade Jordan, a nice move inside, does not get the roll. Monod pulls it away, it's called for the treble. Number 13, Rob Hammond with the treble ball.
Good job by Daniel Mack there. We get a good shot of head coach Jerry Vadeau of the Titans. A half away from the first provincial championship. Help!
Baptiste with a great roll, but does not get it to fall. Bueno now moving back quickly for the Titans. This is off to Brown. It's picked up there by number 12, Guejo, and he's fouled on the play. Number 24, Ramil Sumanag will pick up his first personal foul, the team's first of this half.
Well, both times down the court here, Daniel Mack's got some excellent penetration. Unfortunately, for them, the ball just won't fall.
Zumanod picking up his first personal foul. 36-31, the Titans lead. Ruskin now down low, turns around, tries to go off the glass. Baptiste is there for the offensive board. Darryl Baptiste uses it for two.
It's a good job by both Ruskin and Baptiste, taking it inside against Dejard and Brown, who are a little bit bigger than both of them.
A 3-point lead now for the Titans. Ball's knocked away once again. They battle for it. Jump ball. Daniel Mack has a chance to cut it to a 1-point ball game.
Good hustle by Daniel Mack there. That time Vince picked up his dribble just a little bit too early.
Once again, they move that ball to the left-hand corner before they dish it out. Number four, Darryl Baptiste has 8 points. He tries from the outside. Proskin's there in a battle for the boards, and he'll be called for the push. For number 21, Jeff Proskin, that'll be his second personal foul. The team's first of this half.
Well, I questioned one of the calls of referee Kurt, I should say Kreitzer, in the first half. This time I got to challenge that one with referee Kurtz here. Both guys going for the ball. I think the better thing would have been there was a no call.
Inside, 8 minutes, 15 seconds remaining this third quarter. A 3-point lead for Transcona. Bueno with the ball on Oregas. Bueno trying to get Oregas off his feet. Not able to do so. The bounce pass. They dish it back out. Bueno from three comes up short. Ball falls in the hands of the Maroons.
What an excellent matchup right there. Oregas and Bueno.
Baptiste now in possession for the Maroons. Drives inside, he's called for the turn.
Well, now I got a question, a second call of referee Kreitzer. I mean, they've got a hard enough job to do down there, but I don't know. In order for it to be a charge, Ray's got to be set, and I don't think so. I think he was still moving right there.
Well, no one could accuse you of being a homer, though, Larry.
No, not at all.
That's a good thing. Well, people at home might be getting upset right now. Corey May, English teacher, Daniel Mack High School, if you haven't guessed that so far in tonight's action. Pass comes right in the hands of number 23, Patrick Quigley. And very quickly, the Maroons have their third opportunity to close it to one. And they do so! And as Pedro gets the goal.
Follow Pedro, doing a good job down there.
36-25, and the ball's turned over once again to the Maroons. And they have the opportunity to take their first lead of the game. Baptiste on the baseline move off the glass. This time, Kevin Brown comes down with it.
That's the matchup that Daniel's got to take advantage of. Is Ray Rahanan on Darryl Baptiste. Unfortunately for Daniel, it's just not falling for Darryl.
Inside to Brown, and Brown goes up strong, but doesn't get the roll. And right there, number 13, Rahanan for two.
And what Coach Scott is saying right now, if it's a charge at one end, why wasn't it a charge down there? Good job by Patrick Quigley. Should have been called an offensive charge on Ray Brown.
Oregas answers with two, and we're back to that 1-point ball game. The Titans up by one, 6.5 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Inside to Rahaman, he loses possession. Now with Baptiste, the Maroons have the chance to take the lead. Their second chance down floor. Baptiste pulls up with a short jumper. Bounces out, they look for the rebound. Ball's knocked around under the rim. Origas goes up and he's fouled. So number 10, Ryan Origas, is going to climb with a chance for Daniel Mack to take the lead.
That's a great job by Ryan Origas, but once again, you get a look at Coach Scott trying to talk to Daryl Baptiste. He's got to get in some type of flow there. What happened there? He pump faked about three or four times. He's well inside the paint. He's got to take that shot.
Timeout by Transcona with a score of 38-37 and just 6 minutes, 12 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
Well, once again, as we said at the beginning of the broadcast, very high tempo, very high intensity game. We've got everybody involved. We've got the fans involved, the Titans, the Maroons, and the officials involved. It's an excellent job, excellent atmosphere here, and we're getting to see an excellent ball game.
Provincial 4A Championship Final live from the Duckworth Center at Daniel Mack Maroons taking on the Transcona Titans. I'm glad to be along with Corey Mays.
Right,
and down to
they're
Tony Scott,
the ball.
The coach of Daniel Mack.
To the 21, you got to deny the pass. Okay?
What? He'll go here, he'll go to the point, and he'll kill his dribble. So what? He killed the dribble to stay down. Offensively, you have to make sure if you get to the gap, remember we talked about the gap, get into the gap, you have to be balanced and look strong with a shot. If not, rotate the ball.
Rotate the ball because they don't like playing defense.
You don't have to go for a shot.
Okay?
Let's
go. Ready? 1, 2, 3, defense!
Well, that's an excellent timeout by Coach Scott. What we've got to do, and when he's talking about fitting that gap, we've seen Daryl Baptiste in that gap many times. He's either going to take that shot or he's going to rotate the ball. Unfortunately for Daryl, second-guessing himself all the time, and neither is happening.
At the line, number 10, and his supporters, Ryan Origas. For the first time since the opening tip-off, we have a tie game, and now the chance for the Maroons to take the lead for the first time. Tell by the roar of the crowd that Daniel Mack Maroons have their first lead in this championship final. 39-33, Rahamon comes up short, and the Maroons are going to attack once again. This time a little overzealous, and that pass goes out of bounds.
Good job by Daniel Mack defensively. Good board by Paulo Cuejo. Here's Jeff Proskin hustling, going to get the ball back.
And Kevin Brown comes up with a steal. He goes for a three-point shot. Cuejo getting up to pull down the board. The Maroons lead by one, and quickly they come back up court. Cuejo from the outside. He hits the three. Pardon me, three. We got a four-point Daniel Mack lead.
Well, there Daniel Mack executed offensively, just what Coach Scott had asked for.
Brown now tries to answer. We got a whistle underneath the basket. Three-second violation on the Titans.
Good job by Daniel Mack there in terms of the offensive execution. Daryl Baptiste looking for the gap. The ball wasn't there. Rotated, hit Paulo Cuejo wide open. And once again, in rhythm, squared up. Good shot.
A four-point Daniel Mack lead. Their largest lead of the game. They didn't get their first lead until 6 minutes and 12 seconds remained in this third quarter. And Coach Badu looks on, not sure what to say, as his team has come back, or pardon me, has lost a 10-point lead early in that first quarter. Now they trail by four.
Well, as you mentioned, they came out shooting, and here's Baptiste getting on a roll.
Daryl Baptiste for two, and it's a 6-point Maroon lead. They throw the ball away.
Cuejo's going to take this to the hole.
Cuejo going up and not able to get it, but Origas is there. He takes the ball back out.
Cuejo should have shot that ball.
Back to Baptiste. Baptiste for three.
That would have really hurt Transcona if that one would have gone down.
Quickly, though, the Titans try to answer. Rahamon using the glass, and he's fouled. Pardon me, he's called for the charge.
That's referee Kurtz calling that one. Transcona, what we got, of course, is they're going to have to answer here. We've got Coach Scott right now. Both Coach Scott and Coach Madu. It's a bit of a problem. You're trying to hold a racehorse back. We got Coach Scott here flapping his arms, trying to calm Daniel Mack down, and Coach Madu trying to do the same thing. These kids just know how to play at one speed, and that's quick.
Ray Rahamon with his third personal, and there's a three-pointer from number 12, Paulo Cuejo.
Well, Daniel Mack has come out here on fire. This a good timeout here by Coach Fadu. He can't let this go on any further. He's got to make sure that he sets his Chargers, set them down, calm them down. They're going to have to play some defense, and that's very hard for Transcona because they're a very offensive-minded team.
Don't try to steal the ball. Don't try to double-team anybody else. Just stay with him, all right? Offensively. Okay? Offensively. Go into the stack. Get the ball to him. Okay? Get the ball to him. Don't play with the ball when you're in there. You're going down the sideline. Yes. When you're bringing the ball up, you got to bring it up the middle. Do not bring it down the sides. That's where you're getting trapped and getting in trouble, all right? Okay? Not down the sides. Bring it up the middle. And you got to help that way. Okay? Let's go now. Don't
be patient. You've got a lot of time left for you anyway.
You move your feet and play smart. When you guys done right now, you sucked it up and you played in the lane, your house went back. Continue to do that. Okay?
Hey.
All right,
14 minutes left.
Lots of time left in this game. There's lots of runs that are going to be happening. You have to continue to play hard. Okay? One, two, three.
Good timeout by both coaches there. Coach Fadu, what he wants to Vince Bueno to do is keep the ball in the middle of the floor. Stay away from the sideline so you don't get trapped. We're going to start to see Transcona go inside here offensively.
Daniel Macklin, a 16-3 run in the first 6 minutes of this fourth quarter, and they take the lead, and they come up with a steal, but they lose control. Mohammed now dishes it back out. Kevin Brown, number 11, goes down the baseline, three-point shot. Ball bounces back out, and Guajo pulls it down for the Maroons.
Good job by Daniel Mack in terms of taking away second shot opportunities for Transcona. That's what they're going to have to do.
Let's look inside. That ball is almost taken away by Proskin after it comes loose. The Titans trail by 9. 3 minutes, 33 seconds remain. They look inside, and Proskin with a deflection into the hands of Quigley.
On that timeout, Coach Fadu said they wanted to go to Jazard down inside. But I'll tell you, Jeff Proskin's playing a whale of a game again.
That piece comes up short. Mohammed pulls it down for the Titans.
That piece gone cold again.
Transcona now slowing things down. 3 minutes, 5 seconds remain in the third quarter. They trail by 9 inside to Brown. Brown tries to use the glass, and he's too strong. Guajo able to hold on that one, gets it out of trouble, and the Maroons break midcourt.
That was a great job by Kevin Brown there on the ball cut. Transcona is going to have to continue to look at it. Nice steal by Ray.
Ray Mohammed for two.
Markow, grade 11. A little bit of a rookie mistake there. You've got to make sure that you control the basketball.
Down to a 7-point Maroon lead in this third quarter as we move inside 2.5 minutes.
Ray Rahammond's all over Daryl Baptiste. He's doing an excellent job. Just as Coach Fadu had told him, we don't want you to double. We just want you to play deep. Forced in there by Patrick Quigley, and Transcona's coming back again.
Transcona now looking to cut it down to 5. Dish the pass off to Jazard for 2.
It's a good job by Transcona as they respond to Coach Fadu's timeout. We got Coach Scott's going to come here with a timeout.
Jazard with 17 points and 2 minutes, 2 seconds to go in this third quarter. 42 for the Titans. Daniel Mack with 47, a 5-point lead.
You go back to that timeout with Coach Fadu, you look at assistant coach Brisson, hit the nail right on the head there after Coach Fadu said what he wanted to say. He let the rest of the Transcona players know there's lots of time left, and now they're back in this game.
Test drive on them.
Run the offense, 2 points at a time, and we'll get it in. Keep going to Jeff. If you got to do it this way, or you drive to them, that's fine. But make sure that you guys have the boards. And then when you miss or put it in, get back. There was 3 greens back there. You got to get back on defense and play tough down here. Okay? Remember, they pass. They're setting a pick over here. So fight over it. Talk to each other so that you know the pick's coming. That way the guy doesn't have to fight over it. All right? That's right. Okay? Make a straight pass. They're anticipating, okay? Don't try to steal it unless you have a sure thing. Okay, let's go.
3, 2, 1,
let's go. Come on, Ron.
So don't allow him to do that. okay? Let's go. Go, one, two, three.
.47-42, the 5-point lead for Coach Tony Scott and his Daniel Mack Maroons. Some of the honor roll students at Transcona on our screen.
Great job here for the Transcona Titans. The fans are having a great time. Arregas for two,
and he hits it from the outside. Arregas with 12 points in the game. Haman trying to drive baseline, knocked out of bounds by Park. So he'll remain in possession of the Titans.
As we can see with the Titans, they're trying to go to Jeff Jazard here. And we got Daniel Mack keying in on Daryl Baptiste. The thing is with Daniel Mack, they've got to look at a couple other players. They've got to look at Arregas and they've got to look at Quajo. They're the ones that got them into that lead.
Kevin Brown, number 11, can hit from the outside. Steps, tries to beat Jazard, but Baptiste was there.
Well, on the wing, they tried a little pick and roll there. Oh, and then we got Daniel turn it over. That's about the third or fourth time in this quarter that Daniel Mack has turned the ball over.
Inside a minute and a half remaining in this third quarter, 49-42. Very happy Daniel Mack fans as their team's up by seven. A lot of pressure being put on by the Maroons. Inside to Brown. Doesn't get the roll, but Rahaman is there. They battle once again underneath the boards, and Baptiste comes in with Daniel Mack.
Good job by Transcona as they take the ball to Daniel. Unfortunately for the Titans, that time it didn't fall. Good job by Ray Rahaman on the weak side. What you're going to have to do on the weak side, whether it be Quickly or Quajo, they've got to make sure that they put a body on Ray Rahaman. As we mentioned earlier, he's a great role player, and he can hurt Daniel Mack.
Inside, 45 seconds. Oh, almost sent out of bounds, thrown cross court. Park able to pick it up, and Arregas just jumped back, and he will once again set up the offense for the Maroons.
Bad pass again by the Maroons. What they've got to do is they've got to make sure they control the ball. Daryl Baptiste might want to try and backdoor Ray Rahaman here. Ray has been working so hard against Daryl. He's out there for all the passes. He's got a good screen there set by number 21, Jeff Froskin.
Down to 15 seconds remaining in this third quarter. That 7-point Maroon lead, they'd like to extend it to 9.
You got to go now. Good job by Quajo.
Quajo moves in, but he was fouled before he got the shot away. He will. But hey, there's only 4 team fouls right now, so the ball will be inbound in front of the basket. As Coach Scott getting excited on the side. Just takes a moment to clean his glasses and a chance to look back on the action. 7 seconds remaining. Coach Gadoo's calling out signals for his Transcona Titans.
We need a good cut here and a good pick by Daryl Baptiste. Arregas, good job. Here comes Baptiste.
Ball's knocked away on the floor, picked up by Proskin. Great dish off, and the clock runs out.
Coach Scott wants to talk with referee Kreitzer here. Wendell Park for Daniel Mack was run over there right near the end, and we had Coach Scott really looking for a foul, and he's going to take his, right now, referee Kreitzer's trying to laugh it off, but Coach Scott, what referee Kreitzer's got to understand here. We're playing for the provincial final here.
Well, there's our two officials. They've done a very good job. I know that you've questioned a few of their calls, but we'll go back to Coach Scott and see if he's controlled himself from that last moment of action.
Who's out here? Okay. No, Paulie's out. All right, Patrick, Paulie, who did you have?
24.
Right, you take 24 because you're quicker, and you take 13.
Okay, listen. Right now is a gut check. All right, you got 10 minutes of gut checking. All right, when we have the ball, listen, I don't care if he's wide open sometimes. But if you're going to get it to him, you have to make sure it's a good pass to Ryan on the wing. All right, if you hit him. If not, don't take off. Come back, get the ball. We'll run the offense. Okay? We'll run the offense. Patience. All right? Defensively, you guys are doing a great job playing in the lane. All right? Look how many times. Right now, they're going to go to their big guns. Brown, Ivers, and Ford. Those are the three guys going to be shooting a lot. So we have to play tough defense. Okay? Let's go. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Defense!
Well, Lori, we've got to thank these coaches for letting us into their huddles here and getting some very valuable information. There's less than 10 minutes now remain in this championship final.
Well, just as you said, Blair, we got both coaches doing an excellent job. We got both of them, they have two very fine teams here. We got Bueno trying to go one-on-one here with the Regis, just as he did at the start of the third quarter. Good defense here by Daniel Mack.
Brown from the outside, he comes up short.
Coach Scott's talking about a gut check here. What he's talking about is he knows that Transcona is going to come at him, and Daniel's going to have to step up and meet the challenge. That's what he's saying.
49-42, a seven-point maroon lead. It's a four-point lead for the Titans at the half, but Daniel Mack dominated that third quarter, outscoring Transcona 18-8. Oh, Regis with a nice baseline move. He goes up, does not get the roll, but the ball comes back to Proskin. He puts it up and it pops back out.
Good job by Jeff Proskin. Unfortunately, goes up strong, misses the two.
Inside 9 minutes now remaining. Now foul on the play. Number 10, Ryan Regis will pick up his third personal foul. The team's fourth in this half.
Ryan Regis, he's third. They've got to worry now for Coach Scott. Referee Kurtz calls that Ryan just on Vince just a little bit too tight, but that's what you got to do with Vince Bueno. You got to stay on him because he's that quality of player.
Simona now dishes the ball back out. They look inside to Jazard off the glass. Nice cut by Jazard.
That's Jeff Proskin losing his man. Gets beat on the back door.
49-44, back to a five-point maroon lead.
Once again, Leroy Hammond doing a great job on Daryl. Daryl's got to move a little bit more offensively.
He loses possession, so once again, the Titans quickly try to answer. A foul going on number four, Baptiste, and that will be his third personal foul, the team's fifth in this half.
One of the things that Coach Scott said there between the third and fourth quarter is we got to handle the ball a little bit better. We got to take care of it a little bit better. Right now, Daniel Mack is not doing that, and Transcona, since Coach Scott said, they're coming out strong, and they're going to push them.
Transcona, a lot of supporters here in this provincial final at the University of Winnipeg's Duckworth Center, and you are watching the 4A final on BPW Channel 11. This is a live presentation of high school sports. 8 minutes, 20 seconds remain, 49-44. Let's go down to the Transcona timeout.
Get the ball into him, into you. Don't try to force anything if it's not there. If it's not there, kick it back out and start over again, all right? Now defense, when there's all this movement in here, don't be afraid to switch. We've got the bigger guys anyway, it doesn't matter, okay? So make the switches. That way you won't get bumped around it so much, okay? You can get some steals off of it. If the fast break is there, you take it. If it's not there, set it up, run the offense. Take our time. Okay, it's our game. Let's go. Work hard.
3, 2, 1, time.
Let's go. Okay. If the ball's on your side, you're playing here, bump here. Okay? If the ball goes to the opposite side, you just drop in a pair.
Okay, when the ball is down here, would I sag down?
No, you sag down into the middle. Down into the baseline, weak side. All right?
Well, it's on my side, but boom.
You sag here, right into the lane. All right, right now, we're playing man to man on a made basket. Made foul shot, 22, back there. Let's go.
The front, you gotta hurry up, okay?
Huh? Forget it, then.
To live action, 8 minutes 20 seconds remaining, 49-44. Transcona looking to cut it to three, but number 21, Jeff Proskin, is there on the defensive end, and they got an opening of that, or pardon me, if Park can get it to Wajo for two.
Good job by number 21, Jeff Proskin, on the defensive end. Jeff has got to make sure that he keeps control of the ball, doesn't lose the ball.
Daniel Mack with their first bucket in this fourth quarter. They open their lead back to 7 points. Evan Brown with a turnaround jumper for two.
It's a good job by Kevin as he answers to Daniel Mack bucket.
Kevin Brown answers his first 2 points in the second half.
Shot from the outside. Daniel Mack once again. That's Park pulling down that missed opportunity from Quigley.
Coach Scott wants a little more offensive movement here.
Ball outside to Quajo. Battle for the fours and a foul will go on number 23, Patrick Quigley, and that'll be his third personal foul. The team's sixth in this half.
Danny Mack just a little bit out of sync at this particular moment down at the offensive end. We had a wide open shot for a follow. Unfortunately, it didn't fall. A little bit of extra hustle by Patrick.
Inside, 7 minutes remaining. Evan Brown misses the ball back out. Bueno gives it back to Brown. They look inside for Evan Brown. The ball's knocked out of bounds off of Daniel Mack. For a 6:47, 5-point maroon lead.
Got Coach Scott once again upset with referee Kreitzer.
They're going to give a foul there to number 12, Paulo Coelho, and that'll be his second personal, but more importantly for the Titans, that's going to put them in the bonus situation.
It's a good job by Transcona, however, with the two big men, Desard and Brown. They've done an excellent job. Right there we have the switch. Desard came out, Brown went down, posted up Coelho, and referee Crutcher from the baseline saw Coelho holding. It was a good call.
Coach Tony Scott, Daniel Mack looks on, a little bit disgusted right now, is at the line, is number 11, Kevin Brown to shoot the bonus and he misses. Very quickly the Maroons break up court. Get the ball inside the crossing. Inside, 6.5 minutes remaining, a 5-point Daniel Mack lead. Crosskin gets the ball apart. Mark has to dish it back out.
Once again, Coach Scott upset. I got to agree with him. Daniel offensively not making good passes here.
Rand's going to continue to stay in that man-on-man pressure. Shot from the outside. Quigley comes up short. Well, Hammond just dishes it out to Bueno.
That's Patrick Quigley, second time now. He's missed an opportunity. Daniel's come down three times and they haven't scored. They've got the shots that they wanted, but they just haven't fallen.
Nice dish off to Hammond for two from Bueno.
It's a great job by Vince on the penetration. Cut it to a 3-point Daniel Mack lead.
51-48, the Maroons out in front by three. 5 minutes, 45 seconds remain in this fourth quarter. Quajo now, they put the ball around on the perimeter. Daniel Mack looking for instructions to see what they can do. Not a lot of movement on either side for their offense, though, Laurie.
What we've got to do, Daniel Mack, we've got to get an offensive sink here.
They dish the ball off. Quajo steps in the paint, has it knocked away.
What's happening right now, Daniel Mack, they're starting to get a little tense here. They're starting to tighten up. They're playing not to lose instead of playing to win.
Double ball on the Transcona Titans. So a big turnover at this point.
It's a big break for Daniel Mack.
The clock heads towards 5 minutes remaining, a 3-point maroon lead.
Once again, Daniel Mack standing still. We got to get some offensive movement here.
A lot of times on the Daniel Mack side, there's one, maybe two people moving, and that's it for you. Clock heads towards 4.5 minutes remaining. O'Regas looks to Quajo. Quajo tries to dish it inside. It's knocked away.
That's Quajo's second consecutive turnover.
Transcona Brown, baseline move, tries to dish it off to Desard. The ball's picked up by number 23, Patrick Quigley. And Ray Rahamon will pick up his fourth personal foul, the team's fifth of this half.
That's a great job by number 21, Jeff Kroskin, as he takes the baseline away, comes over and helps. On this particular foul, it's going to give Coach Scott a chance to get some other players into the game. Looks like Daniel Mack's going to burn a timeout here with 4:18 left in the game and nursing a 3-point lead.
Thank you.
our post play has to come in set. I don't want you. I want a hard cut here. All right, right now. Pastor, who's watching you?
13, who's watching you?
Okay. Then you dish off, but you guys have to come to the ball, eh? Come to the ball every time. On defense, switch up. Don't try to steal it, but make sure you're on them all the time. You're making it too easy for them to get the ball over here.
Get a screenshot for Ramil so he can come up to the top of the key and pop that three-pointer.
Okay. You gotta take it too. Okay?
Hard, man. Get on him.
Okay. Work hard on defense. That's where we're gonna do it, okay? On defense. Okay, let's go hard.
3, 2, 1, 10.
Four's out there. Let's go.
Grants Kona fans are into it, and so are the Daniel Mac fans. 4 minutes, 18 seconds remain, 51-48. A very low-scoring provincial final, Lori.
Well, what's happening right now, Blair, is beginning of the game, we had a lot of fast-paced action. Transcona came out. They got out to the big lead. They're firing on all cylinders. Now, with just 4 minutes left here in a provincial final, we got both teams playing in a situation where they're playing not to win but not to lose. We can see Transcona's getting tight. They're making some silly turnovers that they didn't before. Daniel Mack, there's just simply static on defense, and we're in a problem right here again.
And a holding foul there, and I believe that'll go on number 24, Ramel Sunamad. And that will be his third personal foul, the team's sixth of this half.
What we have is Mark Howell takes the ball down to the right-hand side, and what does he do? He kills his dribble. What Danny Mack's got to do is they've got to get some motion here. We've got to forget what's happening. The team that's going to win this game, Blair, is the team that gets back to their original game.
Go back to a nice inbounds play, and right there, number 23, Patrick Quigley for the Maroons.
It's a good job by Quigley, and here comes the Maroon pressure.
Transcona able to break the pressure as we move inside 4 minutes. Bueno from the top of the free throw area. And number 11 gets up there. That is.
Wendell's going to go.
Park, and he goes coast to coast.
That's a great job by Vince on the penetration. Unfortunately for Transcona, the ball just didn't fall.
Wendell Clark, the length of the floor. 55-48, a 7-point lead for the Maroons. Look inside. Brown trying to save it, not able to do so.
Well, I'll tell you, that's good defense. That's good defense by number 21, Jeff Broskin again. Jeff is doing a great job when he's inside. When we have Jazard and Brown switch, and Jazard comes outside, Broskin's doing a good job stopping that initial wing pass.
Daniel Mack with that 7-point lead. They have possession. Number 4, Daryl Baptiste looks inside. Quigley goes up, tries to use the glass. Sumanad comes away with it for the Titans.
That's a good job by Daniel Mack going for the mismatch with Quigley inside. All Patrick's got to do is just put that ball up a little easier. He almost broke the glass there.
Going back to cross court. Bueno for three. His first three-pointer of the game. And it's down to a 4-point Maroon lead.
Well, once again, as you say, that's Vince's first three-pointer of the game. But I'll tell you, that's what gets Transcona clicking.
The fans have jumped up off their seats on the Transcona side. Baptiste trying to answer. He's long. And Bueno pulls it away. Goes up to Brown. Kevin Brown from three-point range. Not successful there. And the Maroons take it back.
Well, that time, Kevin should have taken it right to the hole that time. What we can see, once again, Daryl Baptiste really struggling here. Two games in a row.
Inside, 2 minutes, 10 seconds remain. They look inside, and a steal from Bueno.
The bad pass by Mark Howell. You're going to go into the post. You got to go in with a bounce pass. Can't go over top people.
Inside, 2 minutes remain. That 4-point Maroon lead. They get the ball inside. Rahamon going up over top. Battles for his own boards, and he'll pick up his fifth personal foul, and he'll leave the game.
That's a great block out by number 21, Jeff Broskin. I think what Coach Scott's got to do, he's got to get Ryan Oregas back in the game for Mark Howell.
Rahman will pick up his fifth personal. He scored 10 points in the game, and he'll leave with a minute 49 remaining. His team down by 4, and Daniel Mack will come down to shoot the bonus.
That's an excellent job by Daniel Mack. First of all, Patrick Quigley on the initial defense, but more importantly, Jeff Proskin on the big blockout. But we go and look at this for a lot of people, they might not think that perhaps Ray Rahman is not a big section of that Transcona offense. He really is. As we said earlier in the broadcast, he's one of the best role players in the province this year, and he's the one who's been doing a heck of a job on Daryl Baptiste.
55, 51, a minute 49 remains. Daniel Mack Maroons.
So we can't get it here. We go straight back up to the top of you. We reverse it, and we just work it. All right? All right, if you know, you still do the same thing. You reverse it there, then you go down. All right? Press break. You're throwing the ball in. You two up top. You two on the side.
You're three, Mark.
Okay? No, he's marking it in. Okay? One, two, three, four, five.
Transcona heads back onto the floor. Daniel Mack continuing to talk on the side as they're looking for some options.
We got Coach Scott. He wants to make sure that he's got his message across to his people. We've got Coach Scott. He's taking Paulo Cuejo and Mark Howe, a grade 10 and a grade 11, out of the game. He's countered with Wendell Park, who's in grade 12. Now, as we have a look at the situation here for the Daniel Mack Maroons with 1:49 left in the game. Now Coach Scott is countered with four grade 12s are on the floor, and the only grade 11 on the floor being Daryl Baptiste.
Jeff Pruskin at the line. He's been there four times. He made three of them, but he misses that opportunity. They had Simonaut open. Very quickly, though, they try to come back, and they lose possession. The ball's knocked away again. Daniel Mack has possession. Play a little rattled right now, Laurie.
Well, play a little rattled, as we said. That's a great job by Jeff Proskin. Unfortunately, Jeff, he misses the front end of the bonus, but comes back with a big steal.
I just have one question, Laurie. You teach it, Daniel Mack. When they send out their list of supplies at the end of the year, does one of them include a garbage can lid?
Well, it seems to be, as you say, equipment that comes to almost every final here.
Inside a minute and a half remains. Daniel Mack with that four-point lead, and they are just holding on.
Well, what we've got here is Danny Mack's going to try and melt the clock here a little bit.
But the ball's all taken away. Let's see if there's pressure, and they pick it up. The arrow is in favor of the Maroons. If that would have been a turnover, Daniel Mack would have had it. We move down to just over 1 minute remaining. Shot from Bueno, and there's those tight rims. The ball just pops its way back out. It was halfway down. Travel called on Oregas, and another quick turnover. There's no stopping these Titans. Sumana tries to hit. They do not need these three, so I don't know why they keep pumping from the outside.
We got Coach Badu up. He's trying to calm them down here.
50 seconds remain. Brown from three, and he can't get it to hit.
Transcona's really hurt themselves here. They've taken three three-pointers that they didn't need. They've got Brown and Jussard inside. It's only a four-point difference. They've just helped Daniel Mack big time here. Daniel Mack was unable to melt the clock, and Transcona comes out and does it for them.
Evan Brown picking up his second. But as you mentioned, Laurie, three chances they took from 3 points. There was no need for that. Work it in. Then you still got 50 seconds, 40 seconds to get the ball back and try to score again. This way they could go down by as many as five or six. Now they're going to have to count on those three-pointers.
Well, what's going to happen here now is good foul by Kevin Brown to stop the clock. And we've got Wendell Parks going to go to half. He's got to go to the line. He's got to hit one of these for Danny Mack.
55, 51, a four-point lead. 39 seconds remaining, and here's Coach Badu.
Okay, then we can foul him again, get the next 2 points, okay? Don't try to do it all at once.
Okay? Give you the layup, take the layup.
Okay, now when these guys are shooting their threes, everybody's standing around. You can't stand around. You got to hit the boards. We only got 39 seconds left. Suck it up and hit the boards.
How many timeouts do we have?
One more. Okay, let's go. If you get in trouble, call it. Let's go. Defensively, we're going three-quarter court man-to-man. So we don't challenge it. We're here and playing man-to-man. Hey, no foul on the shot. You get a hand up. Don't foul him. So it's a four-point play.
Let's go, let's go.
Okay, let's go.
No!
One, two, three.
Defense!
Coach Badu likes to get his message out quickly. Coach Scott likes to belabor the point.
Coach Scott wants to make sure that as you get a look there on your screen, 39 seconds left in this contest. Daniel Mack enjoys the four-point lead, 55-51, with Wendell Park going to the foul line.
At the line, number 11, Wendell Park, his first chance in the free throw line tonight. Doesn't get it to fall, they battle for it, and Transcona will come away with it. Foul on number 4, Darryl Baptiste, and that will be his fourth personal foul. 31 seconds remaining. At the line will be number 4, Vince Buono.
Well, what we have, that's the second time that Daniel Mack has missed from the charity stripe. We had Jeff Prosky miss the front of the end of the bonus. Now Wendell Park has missed the front of the bonus. That's a good foul by Darryl Baptiste that particular time, because Wendell was going to go to the, probably go right to the hole or dish it down to Brown. They could have very easily gotten a three-point play out of it.
Wendell has met the line once this evening. He's 1-for-2. And he hits that one.
It's a big hit by Vince. You got to look now for Daniel Mack. You better be ready for some Transcona pressure here.
Bueno hits them both. We got a two-point ball game. Inside 30 seconds.
Transcona is going to have to foul early here.
They'd like to get them down to 10 if they could. Not the kind of guy you want to foul there. Although, as you mentioned before, he did miss the front end a little earlier.
What I didn't like there is we got Jeff Brosky with the ball. Ryan Arregas put it back to Jeff, and everybody left him.
Jeff is 3-for-4, but the last time down the floor, he missed that front end in the very important situation. And Transcona will call their final timeout with just 24 seconds remaining and a two-point maroon lead.
Well, we got Coach Scott here a little bit upset again. What this time, once again, with referee Kreitzer. He wanted intentional foul there, but... I've got to be with referee Kreitzer again this time, although I questioned him on one. I also questioned referee Kurtz on one, but that time it was a good call. Kevin's going for the ball.
And this is the second one. We're looking for a quick two or a three, okay? If he puts both of them in, we got to put a basket in right away, and then we got to foul right away.
Full court man-to-man.
Yes, full court man-to-man. Get on your man. Do not let him get behind you, okay? Don't let him get behind you, okay? Okay, let's go. Let's do it.
No!
One, two.
Stick, I'm not dead.
Do not quit right now.
Let's go.
All right? We come down, they have to foul us. They have to foul us. Once they're down, they always have to foul us. All right? Hey, 1-4, right away, okay? Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Corey, I'm going to hate to see this scenario happen. Cross going to go the line, miss the front end. Transcona will come down and try to fire one up from no man's land, and that'll be it. They still got a lot of time to work it in for two.
That could very easily happen. It's very important. As we mentioned, Proskin and Park have already missed from the charity stripe. This is really big here. Jeff Proskin needs to hit this because the most that Transcona can do in that scenario is come down and tie.
Miss it. Still 20 seconds remaining. Let's take a look and see what's going to happen. They get the ball inside. Sumana goes up. And they're going to tie.
Here comes Daniel Mack. You got to move the ball here.
10 seconds
Just got to get it inside for a two.
Clock moves down to 5. Arregas is going into the ball.
They're not even looking at the basket.
Got to fire it now. We're down in overtime. Transcona. Ramiro Sumana ties it with 15 seconds to go. And we are going to the provincial final in overtime.
That's a real lapse by the Danny McIntyre Maroons. Come down, we get the two. Surprising that Transcona would go for the two and not for the three as they usually do. Get inside to Simon and they tie the game. Daniel Mack, 15 seconds left on the clock. Tons of opportunities.
We've got three more minutes.
And here they are once again, a little bit too slow, and they just simply let the clock run out on them. Big error.
Get the ball inside, and we got lots of shots. After that, if the ball doesn't work inside, kick it out. Be patient, okay? Be patient. Okay? Okay, make sure the pass. Make sure the pass. If it's not there, do it around again, all right? Okay? You got to hit boards out there, okay? Make sure you hit boards.
One shot
over. Let's go. On defense, be tough on defense, all right? Let's go. We got it. Let's go. Go.
Go.
defense. Defensively, we can't overplay. You play straight up. Play in the lane. Weak side. We didn't have any weak side help. All right, we gotta be in the lane. We want shots in here. So penetrate, pull up, take solid shots.
Lori, momentum's gotta be in favor of Transcona right now. We're into overtime. 3 minutes of basketball. 55-55, any part of this game right now.
Well, right now, I got to be straight up and honest here. I do not like Daniel McIntyre's chances. We've got Baptiste on the floor with foul trouble, Regas with foul trouble. What's going to happen now is Transcona that have been out of timeouts, they got another timeout, Coach Scott has another timeout, and right now what's going to happen is Transcona, if they want to win this game, they're going to pound the ball inside. They've got to take advantage of what they can do inside.
Transcona has the height advantage with the tip here. They gain possession just as they did to start the game. Inside to Desard, he has the ball knocked away. No, he loses it, so the goal goes to the Maroons.
Well, just as I said, Transcona doing a good job. They're going inside. What you got to understand, when you got somebody down, you got to put them away. You cannot give them a second opportunity.
Goes up over top of Desard. Oh, Regas is in low, and he's called, pardon me, he was fouled on the place to go to the line to shoot two.
Gerald Baptiste, once again, going cold. He's been very inconsistent down at the offensive end, but doing a great job defensively.
Neil Suminod will pick up his fourth personal foul at the line to shoot two. And the McIntyre's number 10, Ryan O'Regas.
Well, Danny Mack had a chance to salt it away. They've just gone cold from the foul line.
O'Regas successful there as he has been throughout the evening. He's now 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Make that 6 of 6 and a 2-point Maroon lead.
Even though we're talking overtime here, Blair, what we've got to do, both Transcona and Danny Mack, play the games that got you here.
That 2-point Daniel Mack lead. From three, that was Bueno, and it comes up short.
That's a great block out by Patrick Quigley. Two on one here.
Baptiste was open, and they didn't get the ball over to him as Poljo tried to take it in himself.
Paulo had Baptiste open on the wing, should have passed the ball that time. Now Danny's got to play some more defense again.
Once again, Transcona doesn't need to look at that three-pointer, but they try it from the outside. Bueno off the front iron.
There's Daniel with the boards again. Daniel Mack's doing a great job. They've done a great job in the second half and in this overtime in terms of not giving Transcona second chance opportunities.
A minute 40 remaining, a 2-point Maroon lead. Baptiste now on the left hand, moves into the paint. Short jumper off the back iron, but right there is number 22, Quigley. He's fouled on the play at number 30. Dan Richard will pick up his second personal foul. And out to the free throw line, number 23, Patrick Quigley.
Patrick Quigley exceptionally lucky that time there. We're in overtime here right now. You've got yourself a great offensive rebound. You're in amongst the trees. Kick it back out, melt the block. You've got the lead. Daniel Mack has to be more aware of the time that's on the block.
A minute 33 remaining. Fadu looks down the floor. He's got two shots here from Quigley. And he's successful on the first one. All the scoring in this overtime has come from the free throw line.
It's a good job by Patrick. Danny Mack got to put some three-quarter court pressure here.
They're coming full. 4-point lead, so we need two possessions for the Titans if they're going to win this ball game.
A good job by Regas. Wajo's going to steal this.
Wajo picks it up. And the Daniel Mack Maroons have possession.
It's a good job by Quajo. There we go. Great 10 with a smart play. Didn't take it to the hole. Kicked it back out. Daniel Mack's got to melt the clock here. Make sure you keep the ball in the hands of Ryan O'Regas or Daryl Baptiste so that they're fouled.
Baptiste now at the top. We're going to have to start to foul soon as we move inside a minute 10. O'Regas does the smart thing and takes the ball out. Brown looking for the foul. Inside a minute remaining now in overtime.
Transcona's got a foul soon.
O'Regas and Baptiste are doing most of the ball handling for the Maroons. That's what Coach Scott will want to see. Down to 45 seconds. The foul's got to come soon.
Transcona's got a foul. They're waiting too long. Blair, waiting too long.
43 seconds, and they're going to send number 12, Ryan, or pardon me, that's Paulo Cuejo to the line.
Vanscona, I think, waited a little bit too long, but you can't let that get under a minute. Coach Badu is going to burn his time out here, putting a great 10 kid on the line.
Seconds remain, 59-55.
In the lanes, Patrick. Jeff.
Then we can foul again. You have to stop the clock every time the ball is around. So don't pick on Baptiste, but as soon as somebody else has the ball, foul, all right? Stop the clock every time. Then we got to get the rebounds and get it up there. Take the easy twos, okay? If the three is open, take it, but we need the boards off of it, okay? Okay, let's go. It's not finished yet. Let's go.
If they do, they're going to penetrate and pop it out. If they go to the side that Brown's at, he's going to stay on the three-point line. He's going to just pass it back out to him. They're going to get a shot. So what we need to do is make sure we take away penetration. This guy, play in the lane. A play that pass coming back.
So
okay?
No doubles.
Never no doubles. Rebound, protect the ball. Okay? 1-4. 1-2-3, defense.
I have a question, Laurie. Do you think Daniel Mack's going to double anywhere on defense?
No, I don't think they're going to double anywhere. You're lucky. The kid's lucky that there's all these witnesses in front. You don't ask that question. Paulo Cuejo has to hit this.
Cuejo at the line, a great 10 student. He's at the line once and he missed it. This time, though, in overtime, he hits it for a point.
That's a good job right now. He hits this one. It's going to take two threes by Vanscona just to tie.
Ball comes back. It's a five-point maroon lead. All 5 points coming from the free throw line here in overtime. Outside to Brown. Tries to hit it. Comes up short. Battles for his own rebound.
That's a good job by Kevin. Here's
a
steal by
Arestio. And he's going to go down for two. The ball's batted away. We're going to have a foul on number 23, Patrick Quigley. I don't know what happened there, Laurie.
What an exchange we had. Ryan Arregas, what he did is he thought he was just far too open. He went to the hole, and what we've got is Vince Bueno comes down with a good block, and in all that mix, Quigley picks up the foul. It's going to stop the clock with 24, and it's going to put Jeff Jussard on the line. This is great for Vanscona. What a turn of events.
Jeff Jussard, number 33, at the line. His team down by five.
Ryan Arregas has either got to go to the hole hard with that, or he's got to just simply kick it out and try and take some time off the clock. He would have had Vince Bueno here in the forecourt. One-on-one, he could have wasted a good 10 seconds.
In the line, Jussard hits for one. It's down to a four-point maroon lead with 24 seconds remaining.
What's going to happen here? Big pressure coming from Vanscona.
It's down by three.
Almost a steal. Oh, and they didn't foul. They got a foul right away.
Quigley goes in. Oh, he's yes. The line with a chance to complete a three-pointer. And I think it's all over now, Laurie.
Well, that's a big mistake by Kevin Brown and Vince Bueno. As soon as the ball gets in, whoever it is, you have to foul. That time, Vince missed Darryl Baptiste. And Kevin, with a lazy attempt, let Darryl Baptiste go down the sideline. Great job here by Paulo Cuejo. I'm telling you, we've got both teams here. It's just like they want to put their hands in the mouth of the line here and want to pull it out just at the last minute.
Cuejo at the line, trying to complete a three-point play. He's successful, so it's going to take two threes to tie for the Titans with just 15 seconds remaining.
Daniel Mack's got to keep everybody out by the three-point line.
Sunod goes up. Now they got to hit it. They got to get the ball back.
They got to move it here. Move it here. That's game.
5 seconds.
Baptiste going to the hole.
Moves in. Oh! Pardon me, 4A High School Basketball Championship.
I guess, Blair, what they say, a pitch is worth a thousand words. But Ray did an excellent job. He really worked Baptiste big time.
Way to go, Polly. He's got one, but no good job. All right, Marky.
Dejected bench right now on the Transcona side, but they came a long way this year, upset number one ranked team, and had Daniel Mack on the ropes a couple times tonight, Larry.
Well, Transcona's had an excellent year. They've done a great job. It's a great group of kids that a few years ago they won the freshman provincials and worked extremely hard and really developed last year, and here they are this year.
The Daniel Mack Maroons very happy at this moment as they have won the provincial 4A championship, their second provincial championship in the last 4 years. Out on the floor right now just waiting for the award ceremony, and you can see the Daniel Mack side very happy. And as we slide down to Transcona, some disappointed guys, but they have no need to be disappointed. They put on an outstanding performance tonight.
Well, not only tonight, Blair. I mean, Transcona, as we mentioned, over the last 3 years, this group of young men have played some excellent basketball, and they've done a real super job. They've just simply done a great job here in the tournament, as you say, coming in ranked number five. They upset St. John's, ranked number four in their own gym. An excellent ball game, 103-99. And then they turn around last night. They upset the number one Oak Park Raiders, and they take Daniel Mack, who's ranked number two, to overtime.
Overtime victory for Daniel Mack, and we'll go down to our PA announcer, Bill Anthony, for the award ceremonies.
Come forward, please, and receive their finalist ribbons and silver medal pins. Number five, Tim McDowell. Number 10, Dan Maniluk. Number 24, Ramil Sumanad. Number 30, Dan Richard. Number 34, Brad Kulick. Number 4, Vince Bueno. Number 11, Kevin Brown. Number 13, Ray Rahaman. Number 20, Pete Wicha. And number 33, Jeff Jizzard. Also their managers, Kevin Goldsworthy and Jamie Buono. And finally, their coaches, Jerry Badu and Ted Bisson. And now I'd like to call on the captains of the Daniel McIntyre Maroons to receive the championship trophy and pennant, emblematic of the 4A basketball champions. And now I'd like to call on each member of the Daniel Mack McIntyre Maroons to come forward and receive their ribbons and gold medal pins. Number 5, Peter Cattigay. Number 11, Wendell Park. Number 15, Jason Santos. Number 20, Mark Howell. Number 32, George Valentin. Number 34, Charles Carlos. Number 4, Daryl Baptiste. Number 10, Ryan Oregas. Number 12, Paulo Cuejo. Number 21, Jeff Proskin. And number 23, Patrick Quigley. And their managers, Jason Papon and Donald Mojeka. And their coaches, Brian Ottenbright and Tony Scott.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
And now we'd like to present a new award. It's called the Fair Play Award. This award is presented to a player in this game who possesses positive attitude, sportsmanship, and the spirit towards the game. This year's Fair Play Award goes to Daniel McIntyre's number 21, Jeff Proskin. And now the All-Stars of this 1992 tournament. First of all, from Oak Park, scored 20 points in the semifinal, number 34, Jason Harrison. The next All-Star had 27 points in a losing cause in the semifinal with the only dunk in this tournament. From Dakota, number 13, John Hannah. The third All-Star had 19 points in the semifinal, including 4 3-point baskets. Tonight he had a single three-pointer, had 9 points. From Transcona, number 4, Vince Bueno. The next All-Star scored 24 points in the semifinal, 3 3-point shots. Tonight he had 14 in the final with 2 3-point baskets. From Transcona, number 11, Kevin Brown. The next All-Star had 12 points in the semifinal, had 17 here in the championship final. The freshman from Daniel McIntyre, number 12, Paulo Cuejo. And now the most valuable player in this 1992 tournament. In the semifinal, he had 18 points. In this championship final, he had 12, and he was perfect from the free throw line, 6 for 6. From Daniel McIntyre, number 10, Ryan Oregas.
Ryan, Ryan, Ryan,
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for supporting high school basketball. We'll see you again next year. And thank you to the Manitoba Milk Producers Marketing Board for their major sponsorship. Thank you and good night.
Exactly the same thing. Two well-matched teams, very well coached. We saw an excellent exhibition here. And on the Daniel McIntyre side, we've got number 21, Jeff Froskin. He stepped to the fore both last night and tonight and did an excellent job for the Maroons.
Well, before we leave here, as the Daniel Mac Maroons cut down the mesh there, and I'm sure that bill will end up in somebody's pocket over at Daniel Mac. I've got to thank our production crew and our camera people who once again did a great job of bringing you this action here live on BPW Channel 11. So I think we're going to head down over to Sean Coates because I know he has somebody out on the floor. And as soon as he's ready to go, we'll head down there. And I'm sure that he'll have Ryan Arregas with him, who was just an outstanding ball player tonight.
Ryan's done an excellent job. This is going to bring to an end 3 years at Daniel Mac. He's always been one of the leaders of the team. He's been a captain every one of the years. And he just played super throughout the tournament. Very steady indeed.
Okay, let's go down to Sean with Ryan.
Thanks a lot, Blair. Joining me now courtside is MVP of the tournament, player of the game of the championship, Daniel McIntyre Maroons. Number 10, Ryan Arregas. Ryan, first of all, congratulations on the win.
Thanks.
Okay, how does it feel to win this championship? Must be pretty exciting.
Varies. Feels great. Oh, so tired.
Is it something that you would have expected at the start of this year? Did you think you guys would be able to go all the way?
We worked hard. We were hoping to come to the finals. We worked hard to get here, and I'm just happy, you know, we made it, and I'm really happy we got it. Transcona is a tough team. They played us to the end, and we just played our best. I don't know what to say anymore.
What do you think was the turning point in the game? You guys were trailing for a large part of the game, and then you finally got a lead in the third quarter and sort of took it away from there. What really was the turning point for your team tonight?
Probably the beginning, nearest to the third quarter. We had to pick it up. We had to play hard. We can't let it down. This is it. It's our last game. We can't let it down, so we had to take what we got left and put it into the court and just give it our best. And I guess we end up champs.
Okay, that's great. Okay, we'd like to present you on behalf of Videon, your communication center to the world, a game bag for player of the game. Congratulations. Thanks a lot. And now also joining me right now is Vince Bueno from the Transcona Titans. Vince, come on in. Good tournament.
Nice.
Okay. Vince, I know it must be disappointing to lose, but you played a very good tournament. Your team played very well, and I guess a lot of people didn't expect you to go this far. Tell me what the season's been like for you as a whole.
Well, all together we thought we were confident that we could take anyone in the province. Just we had to work hard, and a lot of people say we can play defense, but when we get down to it, we will play defense to try to stop anyone.
You guys also play a very good team game. I noticed everyone touches the ball, everyone contributes. Has that been a big part of the plans for your team this season?
Well, yeah, we try to work it down low and then go. That's basically what we try to do, but if they double on us, we'll hit the guys outside for the threes and hope they drop.
Okay, thanks a lot. Congratulations on a good season and on second place. Thanks a lot. Nicely done. Back to you, Blair.
Thank you very much, Sean. Well, congratulations have to go out to Daniel Mack and Glen Lawn for winning the championship, as well to Dakota and Transcona for great performances here in the final action. Well, from the University of Winnipeg Athletic Center, I'd like to thank Sean Coates, who was down on the floor, Lori May, our color commentator, and I'm Blair DeGray. We want to thank you for joining us and hope to join us once again as BPW Channel 11 covers outstanding amateur sports action right here on BPW Channel 11.